Oh, Mama! Oh, they're soft as a chinchilla's belly. I love the way the bears are boogieing.
Pasha exclaimed as she giggled and wiggled. She started to remember all of the things she used to love about nature. That evening, as Pasha put on her new PJs, she had lots of questions for her father.
Do plants and trees breathe? And before people, did animals make the rules? Can I be the dancing girl-rilla in these pajamas?
He laughed and replied,
"If you jump in bed faster than a little cheetah, I'll tell you a story. Maybe the answers will come to you in your sleep."
Pasha hopped into bed and snuggled into her pillow. Her father had barely started the tale when Pasha drifted off into a dream. It began with a whale meeting a hummingbird. Something that doesn't happen in just any dream. This enormous whale called out to the wee bird,
"Help! Help! I'm drowning!"
yelled the whale. The little hummingbird was certainly shocked and surprised, as she didn't know a sea creature could drown. But she flew quickly to the whale's side, and the whale gasped.
"Something is stuck in my blowhole, and water is getting into my lungs, so I can't breathe."
Hummingbird looked closely at the hole in the top of the whale's head, and sure enough, there was something inside. She used her tiny beak and all of her strength to pull out a plastic bag from the whale's spout. Whale spluttered out water, took a deep breath, and said,
"Thank you for saving my life. I try to live peacefully in my ocean home, but the waters are changing, and there are fewer fish in the sea."
"You're welcome. I feel lucky to be able to help."
The hummingbird whistled, zipping over a tree branch overlooking the sea. Hummingbird was really quite ruffled about what had happened.
"Something's really gone mad with the world. My feathered friends love to sing and spread seeds, but lately, when we come back home, our nests are gone."
"No wonder there are so many angry birds."
"And my bee brothers from the pollination keep disappearing too."
Although the creatures hadn't noticed her, Pasha was watching from behind a tree. She was amazed by the courage of the hummingbird and couldn't believe something so small could be so strong. Pasha was about to whistle to the bird when a jaguar appeared in a suit and a tie. After hearing whale and hummingbird's scary stories, Jaguar looked very sad.
"OMG, Jaguar, what's wrong? You look terrible,"
said the concerned hummingbird.
"The jungles are shrinking day by day. Something in the air is making the weather act strange. Things keep going this way, I might lose my job,"
said Jaguar, panting and ripping off his tie.
"Time, like the rain that fills our watering holes, is running out."
Pasha wanted to join the animals so much that she climbed the tree, sitting on a branch near the floating hummingbird. Pebble tumbled out and shouted from the grass.
"The soil is trashed and the mountains are being mined for their treasures. I'm stuck between a rock and a hard place."
Pasha heard a voice and felt a rumbling in her stomach.
"They've cut down my forest and the planet can't breathe without us,"
said the mighty tree.
"Is that tree talking? Should I climb off?"
Pasha wondered. She looked down and saw a gorilla mask on the ground.
"Maybe if the other animals think I'm one of them, they'll let me join in."
Ooh, ee,